As many of you might know, I made the switch over to DaVinci from Adobe Premiere Pro, and I've been using Adobe Premiere Pro for the past 7 years. Yeah, I never thought I'd see the day. But the real question is, why did I switch over? In this video, I'm not gonna have DaVinci and Adobe Premiere side by side and telling you guys the different features that they both have, but more so the pros and cons that I have with DaVinci coming from Adobe Premiere Pro. You know, for the past 7 years, I've been using Adobe Premiere Pro, created some of my most favorite work, whether it was professional work or passion projects. And I never thought I'd see the day where I switch over, but there has been some issues with Adobe Premiere Pro that hasn't changed. And one of them being is the crashing. I've been experiencing crashing now with Adobe Premiere Pro for quite some time, and it's kind of annoying. Now, I understand in the past years there's been improvements with Premiere Pro and the updates with performance-wise, but the stability just isn't there. And the crashes just hold me back, and I just knew I needed to change. And I've been watching tons of YouTube videos like Quasi, Jake, Gerald Undun, and I know that a lot of them work in DaVinci, and I decided to give it a try and never looked back. A lot of people know DaVinci for coloring. A lot of big films, Hollywood, blockbuster films get colored in DaVinci, but no one really looks at it as like a replacement for Adobe Premiere or Final Cut. When I started doing research on the program and realizing how powerful of an editing software it was, I knew that if I could do what I did in Adobe Premiere in DaVinci, then it was worth the move. Did I mention that DaVinci was free? Yeah, it's free. And a lot of times when you hear the word free, you think of mediocre or you think like a 30-day trial, but it's actually free. And the crazy part about it is that you can actually do professional work with the free version, but if you do want to upgrade to the studio version, there's a few things that I will share later in this video that comes with the studio version. So let's go ahead and talk about what I love about DaVinci. Now, the first thing we're going to talk about is what everyone knows DaVinci for, which is its powerful color grading system. And so for me, when I first got into film, color has always been one of my weaknesses. I just haven't really put as much focus into it. But as I kind of dove more into color theory, I started to understand that color is very important. It almost sets the mood and tone for how you want your audience to feel when they're watching your film. When you look into DaVinci's color grading system, at first, everything looks super advanced. I mean, there's this thing called nodes. Like, what are even nodes? And I found out that nodes act like adjustment layers, kind of like in Premiere Pro. But once you understand how powerful DaVinci's color grading system, I mean, Premiere Pro just looks outdated. It just looks historic. Now, another thing that I do love about DaVinci, I feel, is that the playback, rendering, everything about that is much smoother than it is in Premiere. It obviously depends on the type of computer you're running, but to me, in DaVinci, I find that footage plays back a lot easier. When I moved over from Adobe to DaVinci, I was kind of worried about my keyboard shortcuts. Now, luckily in DaVinci, you're able to customize that. So being able to import my layout from Adobe into DaVinci was nice, and I didn't really have to relearn different shortcuts. The Adobe Creative Cloud, I think for students, starts at $20 and then goes to $30 if you're not a student. I think it's like $252 per year, or if you want the entire Creative Cloud, I think it's like $52 per month. But with DaVinci, it's a one-time $300. Or if you purchase a Blackmagic camera, you get that program for free for lifetime. And that to me was like pretty awesome. If you use a GoPro or any action camera, you'll love this feature. It's called a lens correction. It helps with distortion around the edges, and you won't really need a third-party plugin like you would in Premiere. Another thing I love about DaVinci is how all of the programs are in one program. Now, what I mean by that is when I used to use Adobe Premiere, I would have to export my audio out into Adobe Audition, and then I would have to use my effects in Adobe After Effects, and I would just have to export into different programs. Whereas here in DaVinci, you have your color tab, your fusion, your export all in one. So it's really nice to have that. So another feature I love about DaVinci is the stabilization. Now, back when I used to use Premiere or After Effects, you would use Warp Stabilizer. But DaVinci, I feel like you have more options and the settings you can adjust more, and my footage just comes out a little more cleaner and stabilized than Warp Stabilizer. If you're experiencing flickers in your video from like time lapses or floral lights, then DaVinci has an effect called deflicker. It's super nice and convenient, gets rid of the flickers, because back when I was using Adobe Premiere, I would have to use a third-party plugin, but here in DaVinci, it comes with the studio version, so it's really nice and convenient. Now let's go ahead and talk about some cons of DaVinci that I sort of miss in Premiere Pro. The first one is plugins. I realize that when you rely on plugins for transitions or effects in Premiere Pro, it's really easy and accessible to get them because there's a lot of people using them. Whereas DaVinci, if you want a certain effect or transition, which you have to end up doing some digging around on YouTube or making it from scratch, which can lead to spending more time on that, which can slow you down in the workflow. Another con to me after using DaVinci for some time is the Fusion page. Now, I don't know if I haven't spent enough time in the Fusion page, because when I worked in Premiere, I would rarely touch After Effects. I would open it up here and there for simple, complex type of effects, but I would never go deep into it. So from my experience, if you work in After Effects quite a lot, I would stay in After Effects because Fusion can be a little confusing. Now, I do know that you can create the things you do in After Effects in DaVinci, but from a person who doesn't really know much about that side of things, I would say stick to After Effects because it could take a lot of time to get back up to speed with that, with Fusion. Couple of things that the studio version has that the free version doesn't. The first one I really love is the deflicker. Now, if you have fluorescent light or you're shooting a time lapse and you have flicker in your video, that helps it take it away. It's a cool effect in DaVinci. The second is they have a denoiser. So if you have grain in your video and you want to help denoise that, it's pretty cool. Now in Premiere Pro, I had a magic bullet suite, or you have to have some type of third-party plugin to basically take those noisy grains away. And here it's in the program. Another feature that comes in the studio version but doesn't come in the free version is lens correction. And like I said before, if you're working with action cameras or you're working with GoPros, and you want to have those less distortion on those edges, lens correction helps with that. So with the studio version, you're also able to use GPU acceleration, which helps with performance and playback, and also when you're using heavy effects on your video. You're also able to play back 10-bit 422 footage. Compared to the free version, you can't really do that. So if you're working with a GH5 or any cinema camera with high bit rate footage, then you might want to be looking into upgrading into the studio version. After using DaVinci for the past 7 months, I almost open up files back in Premiere and don't know like why I was editing in Premiere. I almost feel like I wish I moved sooner. The fact that it's free just kind of makes it like, why not try it? You know, and a lot of times, as for me, I was like, I really don't want to take the time to learn a completely new program. How long is it going to take for me to get back up to speed with work from Premiere Pro? Because I knew the shortcuts and I knew the tools in the back of my hand. But with DaVinci, it was a complete different program that was foreign to me, and I just didn't know how long it was going to take. But after a few weeks, I got the tools down and realized that it was a really awesome program to use. And the reason being is because one of the first things that really caught my attention was when I worked in Premiere, I would have to export it to Audition or After Effects or whatever that was. But with DaVinci, everything is in one program. To close this video out, moving from Adobe to DaVinci was a successful move. I wish I did it sooner. I was just afraid that I would have to relearn everything, and because I was so busy with work, I was scared that my learning curve and my workflow would slow down. But after a few weeks of learning the shortcuts and everything, I was able to get back up to speed, and now I can take on client work and know that I can deliver everything like I did with Premiere in DaVinci. With that being said, guys, thank you so much for watching. Leave a like, comment, subscribe. Comment down below if you're thinking of moving to DaVinci or some of the problems you're encountering in Adobe Premiere, and I would love to hear it. Like I said, I wish I did it sooner, and it's free. Free to download, free to try out. Try it out for yourself, and if you like it, go to the studio version and not have to pay monthly for it. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.